All right, so we shall continue with our lessons on the factors of production. We started with the land, and we said land is also a factor of production, which is given by nature. So anything that is given by nature, which helps in the production of goods and services, we classify it to be land. The next factor of production that we'll look at is labor. All these factors are just resources that are put together to manufacture or produce goods and services to satisfy human wants. So when we are talking about labor, then we are referring to all human efforts or capacity used in the production of goods and services. So the human aspect of the production process, so when you enter into a manufacturing plant, any human being at all that you see there engaging themselves in operations of machines, supervising, all those people put together, we call them human effort or human capacity, and we classify them under labor. We can also say that it is the amount of physical, mental, and social effort used to produce goods and services. So once again, it has to do with the human effort or human aspect. It also supplies the expertise where you see supervisors, the technicians, those that are having the expertise in operation of machines and experts. It also put together manpower and then service needed to turn raw materials into finished and semi-finished goods. You can also say that sometimes we call them human resource. So not only labor, sometimes you hear the word human resource and we are referring to the human aspects. Then we can classify them under skilled, semi-skilled and unskilled based on what they can do. So those who are working based on the specific training they receive or education, which has to do with a skill, something that they can use their mind to do, we call them skilled. Then semi-skilled have to do is we are low level of skill and apply some part of manpower. Then when we are talking about the unskilled, these people were basically based on their strengths. They don't really apply any skill obtained from a training or education. In our topic under labor, we are going to look at these issues in details. Let's look at some of the characteristics of labor. What makes this different from any other factor of production? The first thing we will look at is that it's geographically and occupationally mobile. So mobile here is talking about movement, and geographically here is talking about location. So what we are saying is that by location, labor can move from one place to another. So if you are within the workforce, you can work here, or you can move to Tema and go and work. You can move to any location at all and go and work. And then occupationally mobile means that you can engage yourself in different type of economic activity. So a labor is not limited to a particular economic activity. You are required or you are free to engage yourself in any kind of economic activity at all which your strength will permit. Then the reward for labor is wages. At the end of the period agreed upon, you'll be paid an amount of money for the work that you have done, which we call wages. Then efficiency differs. Efficiency is how best the labor can perform its work. It differs from one labor to another. So the capacity of labor A will differ from that of labor B. It can be more efficient or less efficient, depending on the training the person receives, the kind of environment the person finds itself. And even sometimes the reward, which is wages, also determines the efficiency of labor. The labor cannot be separated from the laborer. So we cannot say that what you can do can be done without your presence. It doesn't work like that. Anytime there is a need for labor, the laborer or the one who is doing the labor must be present. So if I'm a teacher, what I'm doing now is my contribution. This cannot be done without my presence. So anytime that the labor is required, the laborer must also be present. Then we say that labor perishes. So whatever you engage yourself in there, within the shortest possible period of time, it will come to an end. So if you are at the production floor and you produce some goods and services, the effort you put in that day has expired. And then the following day, you have to come. That is why every day you see labor engaging themselves in a continuous activity. Then labor is an active factor of production. We have passive and active. Remember during the our lesson on land, we said that land is passive. Labor is active, which means that labor can perform work on its own. It doesn't need support from anywhere. So a human being can wake up and decide to do something. Unlike land, that nothing can come out of it until a human being or any other factor of production make use of it. Then labor is also a human factor. We talk about it. It is a human aspect of the production process. Let's then now go ahead to look at the importance of labor. So it helps in the production of goods and services. When you enter into any manufacturing plant, you can see that most of the works are performed by labor. Even where there are machines, it's human being that work with the machines. Where the machines are even automated, when there is an issue with power supply or any issue, it is human being that help to get the machine going. And where the system of production is labor intensive, then you can see a lot of labor that are helping in the production of goods and services. And when goods and services are produced, the same labor also contribute to economic growth. So there is going to be high growth in the gross domestic product, which refers to the products or goods and services that are manufactured in the country within a given period of time. It also as a result of the effort of labor. Then provision of personnel. It provides different kind of personnel at all level to help in the production process. Those that are skilled are there, unskilled are there, semi-skilled are there, depending on the type of production process and then the type of labor that will be demanded. Then it also provides employment. So people are hired to work at specific production plants, and then they are paid for that. Then they also help in the operations of machines. So there are some machines that need the assistance of human beings before they can function well. It is the effort of labor that is applied to help this or to make this possible. Also, it influences other factors of production in the sense that other factors of production cannot work actively without the effort of labor. So labor in this sense help all the other factors of production in the production of goods and services. Then when this is done, then the one who engages itself in the labor process, where we refer to as the reward is wages, also go home with income. So it provides income for the laborer. So these are a lot of importance that are associated with the human aspects of production, which we refer to it as labor. Thank you.